So, just to revise what we have done in this chapter, we have started with a consumer, we have talked about how he selects a bundle that would give him maximum level of satisfaction given all the constraint this consumer has. And of course, the maximum level of the satisfaction, we use utility to represent that satisfaction. So, mathematically I can see what a consumer is trying to do. Consumer is trying to maximize his utility, and again I am taking only two goods in this world, one can take n goods. As long as n is finite, we are fine with it, and we maximize it with respect to x 1 and x 2. And of course, what we have started with, we have taken some axioms that this utility should satisfy, and those axioms are rationality axioms, continuity, monotonicity and convexity. Again, I am not saying that all of us, our preferences satisfy all these axioms, but what I am talking about is true when these axioms are satisfied. And of course, what I am talking about may be true even if some of these axioms are not satisfied, but I am talking about only the cases where these axioms are satisfied. And this utility maximization has to be done with respect to some constraint, and the constraint, the budget constraint we take, P1 x1 P2 x2, should be less than or equal to I. P1 is the price of good 1, P2 is the price of good 2, x1 represents the amount of good 1 and x2 represents amount of good 2, and I is the income of this person. And here we have signed less than and equal to, but remember here what we said, that these axioms should be satisfied, monotonicity should be satisfied, it means more is better. So, we cannot have a situation in the optimal level where P1 x1 plus P2 x2 is less than I. Why? It means some of the income is left, this person does not derive any satisfaction from leftover income. In real life, it is possible that a person derives some satisfaction from having some money left in his pocket, but the way this problem has been framed here, the person's satisfaction depends only on his level of consumption of good 1 and good 2. So, he does not get anything from keeping some money left in his pocket. So, there is no point having considering this situation, okay? Because by increasing x1 and x2, this person would not lose anything, but will be able to increase his level of satisfaction, or that is utility. So, that is why in optimal level, this has to be true with the equality sign. So, right now we are going to consider a problem where the utility maximization problem is given here under the constraint this, okay. In other word, graphically what we are saying, that here we have our indifference map and here is our budget constraint, okay. Fine, and this is the optimal bundle. This is what we have done. Now, let us look at this problem from little bit different angle. Rather than taking indifference map, and what is an indifference map? It is set of some indifference curve, so that we get clear picture of this person's utility or this person's test. So, let us take just one indifference curve, and this is this, let us say this is the u naught, and let us say we are taking u naught here. Now, here what we are talking about? We are talking about that we have certain budget constraint, and under this budget constraint, what is the maximum level of utility that can be achieved by this person. Now, let us turn this problem little bit, you know, in the opposite direction. We say that this person wants to achieve this u naught level of utility, which is same as this U naught. Okay? How much, what is the minimum level of income he needs to get this U naught level of utility? So, what is happening? P1 and P2, these are market determined, that is how we are taking, because we are talking about consumer. P1 and P2 is, it is from the market. An individual, let us say that so far we are taking that individual is not able to influence P1 and P2, we are talking about that scenario. So, the budget, the cost of having, let us say X1 and X2, X1 amount of good 1 and X2 amount of good 2 is going to be P1 X1 and P2 X2. And what we are trying to say that this has to be minimized. This, what we are saying that we should be able to achieve U naught. Now, how can we achieve U naught? We can take any bundle. Let us say if we take a bundle here, that will give us U naught utility. A bundle here, that will also give us U naught utility. A bundle here will also give us U naught utility. Okay? This bundle is, let us say, x11, x21, or it is a 0.1. Similarly, what we have here is x2, here is x3. Okay? And how can we, what is the idea? To minimize the expenditure. I should achieve, let us say if I am that consumer, I should be able to reach to this utility level by spending as less as possible. So, what we are trying to do basically, we are trying to minimize. Let me write it to this side. So, I will write the earlier problem this side. What we are saying, minimize P1 X1 plus P2 X2 such that U of X1 comma X2 is equal to U naught. Did we talk about earlier that maximize U of X1 and X2 with respect to X1 and X2. Again, here also it is with respect to X1 and X2, because X1 and X2, a consumer can decide the amount of X1 and X2. So, what we have here is such that P1 X1 plus P2 X2 is equal to I. Now, let us look at these two problems. What is happening is, so what we can do here, let us look at this problem, the new problem. What we can do here, P1 plus X1 plus P2 plus X2 is equal to, let us take K, where K is any number. So, for different number of K, if we try to draw this, because this is a line, how would it look like? Downward sloping. Slope is again going to be equal to minus P1 by P2. Here also is slope is minus P1 by P2. Okay? And similarly, we can draw for different values of K. And this is the optimal bundle. This is the bundle, let us say X star. And here is, let us call it also X star. In the old problem, just to distinguish X star in the new problem. What we have done here, we have taken the indifference map, okay? And then we have taken the budget constraint. And what we have done, we have started checking with the, what is the highest level of indifference curve that can be achieved under this budget constraint. And we have figured out that X does not, or X not 0, X star 0 is the optimal bundle. Now, what we are doing, we are from here, we figure out that X star dot, X star 0, the utility level is U naught. We take that utility level and we draw only one indifference curve, where utility level is U naught. Okay? Fine. Now, what we are doing, we are drawing a set of a family of this line P1 X1 plus P2 X2. Of course, different line corresponds to different value of K. And what is this K? K, a better representation would be E, because it is expenditure on X1 and X2. These are iso expenditure lines, I can say. We take any bundle here, here the expenditure is going to be the same in both of these cases, that is what it represents. So, can you say any relation between x star n and x star naught or x star 0, any relation? They are going to be the same, they are going to be the same. Why they are going to be the same? That this line is going to be the same as this line, and this indifference curve is the same as this indifference curve. Again here it is very clear that in both the condition, both the scenarios, the tangency condition have to be satisfied. So, again it will be tangent at the same point. In fact, we can overlap. What we are doing here? We are varying the indifference curve and keeping the budget line fixed. And what we are doing here? We are varying the budget line, in the other word expenditure line. Budget line is also an expenditure line. We are varying the expenditure line while keeping the indifference curve fixed. So, basically these two are dual of one another. If we solve these two, we reach to the same conjunction bundle. It is clear? Okay. So, if we solve it, what do we get here? Let us say for x 1, instead of using star, let me use term called m. I will explain what does this m mean. Okay. This is x 1 m is a function of p 1, p 2 and I. Here u naught is not fixed. Okay. What are the parameters? P 1, p 2 and I. So, x 1, the optimal level of consumption of good one should be given as a function of parameters in this system, and the parameters are p 1, p 2 and I. Is it clear? Similarly, let me write here x 1 h, again I will explain what is h. Only thing that you should remember at present, that this is the optimal level of consumption of good one and this is the optimal level of consumption of good one here in this system. And this should be a function of, what are the parameters here? P 1, P 2 and u naught, because here u naught is fixed. Here u naught is fixed. And also what we can say, I is equal to E of P 1, P 2 and u naught. Why? What is I? I is P 1 x 1 plus P 2 x 2. What is E? E is nothing but P 1 x 1 plus P 2 x 2. We are checking, we have set up the problem such that this I is equal to this u naught. And what we have learned is that x 1 m P 1 P 2 I is equal to x 1 h P 1 P 2 u naught. This is what we have learned. This is an identity, not just equal to, this is an identity. This is always true. I can write it further, if you pay attention to this, that x 1 m P 1 comma P 2 and I is E of P 1 comma P 2 and u naught. Nothing, but I have used this equation here. Is it clear?
Yes.